For about the last 30 years, people have started to look at the way in which the bones really document the evolutionary transition between traditional dinosaurs and living birds. But today, we're able to really study living birds in a whole different way, as well as fossils. We're able to use CT data, CAT scan data, to be able to take new looks at the bones, build computer models to be able to look at how the animals may have flown in the past. We're even able to use other kinds of data to look at the brains of these ancient dinosaurs and see how they compare with birds today.
Birds, although they might seem ordinary because we see them all the time, they're actually really extraordinary creatures. They have a lot of specialized qualities. These traits come from dinosaur ancestors.
There's so many striking bird-like qualities of dinosaurs. In terms of their skeletal structure, they had hollow bones and many features that are now used by birds for flying, but in dinosaurs were used for all sorts of different things.
Most dinosaurs had feathers. There's very close relatives of the Tyrannosaurus rex that had feathers. There's even much more primitive dinosaurs that had feathers.
In living birds, we know that feathers are used for many different functions. They're used for locomotion, but they're also used for camouflage and display and for thermoregulation. And probably all of these functions were important during the evolution of feathers as well.
Dinosaur eggs and nests are a really unique source of data, including specific nesting styles and egg shapes, the arrangement of eggs in a clutch, and then in rare cases where we have an adult dinosaur preserved on top of the eggs, we can infer things about whether this dinosaur was brooding or not.
By the time that birds evolved the ability to fly, they already had a flight-ready brain, because we've been able to show that even much more primitive things that didn't have the ability to fly, things like Velociraptor, Troodontids, Oviraptorosaurs, all have a brain which is identical to the earliest birds.
The dinosaurs didn't go extinct 65 million years ago. We still have them around today. You can see them in your backyard, you can see them everywhere.